I was recently in the Dominican Republic with Synergy Mastermind, and I had an opportunity to interview 10 of the top real estate developers in all of Canada. And I asked them one simple question: what advice would you give to new developers getting into the industry? In this video, they're spilling the beans on their journey and their priceless advice if you want to follow in their footsteps. This is a quick masterclass on land development from some of the best in the industry.
Honeybee Development Group. I'm based out in Vancouver, BC. One piece of advice I would give developers or people who want to learn about it would be to make sure that your team is solid. So that includes your architects, your partners, your financing partners, your builder, and everybody in between.
Yeah, my name's Colin Ernst. We're in Moncton, New Brunswick. And the piece of advice I give to new developers is to seek out and find a mentor in the space. You don't know what you don't know. They're there to help you, guide you, and in development, what might seem like a small mistake can cost quite a bit. So invest in yourself, find a mentor in the space, and grow with them.
Hey, my name is Dale from Develop with Dale. I think one piece of advice that I would give to new developers starting out is just to really niche down. Pick your market, pick your asset class, even pick your neighborhood, and get really hyper-specific, and that is going to save you a lot of time and avoid a lot of analysis paralysis.
Hi, I'm Jeff Lawrence from Twisted Cedar Properties in Orangeville, Ontario. Any advice I could give for new developers coming into the space is implement. Just don't waste so much time and now analyzing. You really have to just take the leap and do it. And there's people there to support you so that you don't make all the biggest mistakes.
Hey, my name is Kris Bucci. I'm from Victoria, BC. I'm a developer out there doing low-rise residential development. My big piece of advice is hire professionals. I fell in the trap of trying to do everything myself, from doing all the planning, budgets, and even swinging a hammer. Hire the professionals, be the developer, let other people do the work that they're meant to do.
Hey guys, Jason McNeill here. I am a mortgage agent with the Findlay Mortgage Team out of London, Ontario. And one important piece when looking at a development is understanding what your NOI can support from an evaluation standpoint, as well as a loan size, so you can see how much money you might have in the deal or be able to pull out once that development is completed. So biasly, connect with a mortgage broker and make sure that your numbers are right.
I'm Mandy, Resendes. Company is Twisted Cedar Properties with my partner, Jeff Lawrence. We're from Ontario, and my one piece of advice would be don't get bogged down or intimidated by what other people are doing. Don't compare too much. Get out and do what you do, and trust yourself that you know more than you think you know. Just go do it.
Hey everybody, Darren, Voros here from the Voros Group. My one piece of advice for anybody getting into development for the very first time is to think a little bit bigger. I think a lot of times we get into development and we think we have to start with a single family dwelling and then a duplex and then a triplex, and then we get to graduate from there and go to a fourplex and a sixplex and an eightplex. If you want to start at 8 and 10 unit buildings, you can absolutely do that. So don't worry, don't think about starting small and growing from there. You can always start bigger and expand from there, and you'll be glad you did.
What's good, everybody? My name is John Benitez, and I'm from Dijon. And my advice for new developers is to reach out to people that are doing it and have done it, because you need their support and help, because there's a lot of unknowns that come your way and sleepless nights. And these people will help you and guide you, and so that you won't have sleepless nights.
Hi, I'm Roseanne Selsey from Selsey Properties. I develop in and around the Kingston area in Ontario. My advice or tip would be to get yourself a really good project management type system so you can track every step that you need to do in your projects. Especially with development, you'll have different projects at different parts of the process. And then my second tip is lean on someone else who's doing something bigger and better, another development, because you're always going to need advice or just someone to have a second set of eyes on what you're doing, because things come out of nowhere for any development project.
Hi, my name is Sarah LaRiche, and the one piece of advice I would have for people is development is way more diverse than just building a building. There are a lot of ways that you can get into it and be a part of the process without necessarily having to understand construction or actually build the building. So you can surround yourself with people that are doing development. You can invest your funds with people that you meet and are doing developments actively right now. But there's also multiple exit points, which is something that I just have revamped my path, thinking originally that I was going to build a building, and now I'm looking at, let's flip the paper. And that was a really cool aha moment for us, where we decided that instead of building this building, let's let the experts do it. We found an awesome opportunity. Let's cash out here and move on to the next.
If you're an experienced real estate investor and you want to surround yourself with other like-minded, high-achieving individuals from across the country, check out synergymastermind.ca. If you're an aspiring developer and you'd like to learn how to get into development, you can check out my course at darrenvoros.com. You can always follow me on Facebook and Instagram, where I post regularly. Thanks so much for watching, and I'll see you in the next video.